Let me give you some highlights that we've been able to learn from him today. Right now, there are 667 COVID-19 cases in Tennessee. That includes 2 deaths from the virus. Knox County has 15 of those cases. And we're also learning this afternoon, right here, officials at Midway Elementary School in Claiborne County saying students and employees may have been exposed to COVID-19 on March 9th, 11th, 12th, and 13th. All students and employees should quarantine or shelter in place for 14 days from the 13th, which is Friday, March 27th. And let me let you know that we are continuing to try to fix that audio from the governor in Nashville. As soon as we get it, we will bring you the information. If not, we are watching his speech and we'll give you the highlights from what he has to say. Bo?
We are continuing to track the impact of COVID-19 as more businesses and organizations announce or at least extend their closures.
Yeah, Oak Ridge Schools, for example, extending its closure to at least April 15th. Superintendent Dr. Bruce Borcher saying in a statement that he intends to use the district's 10 stockpiled days, expecting the governor to extend the statewide closure for other schools in the days ahead. So we'll be looking for that. He says Oak Ridge Schools will seek multiple waivers for the school year.
And the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame announcing today that the 2020 induction ceremony, originally scheduled for this June, has now been postponed until June of 2021. Hall of Fame class of 2020 will now become the class of 2021, and the 2020 recipients of Trailblazers of the Game, the 1980 U.S. Women's Olympic basketball team, will now become the 2021 recipients. All tickets bought by guests will be automatically refunded by Ticketmaster and the Tennessee Theater box office.
Blackberry Farms saying it is temporarily pausing hotel and restaurant operations until April 30th, and cat buses are still running, but asking passengers to limit their trips to essential travel only. Knoxville Area Transit is not requiring bus riders to pay any kind of fare until further notice, and asking passengers to take seats away from the operator and other passengers.
And keep this in mind, starting tomorrow, the city of Knoxville's residential trash contractor, Waste Connections, will be limiting trash and recyclable pickup service to content of carts only. So keep that in mind. Only what you can get in your trash can, basically. Any excess material outside of carts and bulky waste items, such as discarded TVs, furniture, will not be collected. Waste Connections saying the new protocol is a way to protect employees during the coronavirus outbreak. City also saying the Public Service Department may be cutting back on residential brush pickup in order to address other higher priority services. And we have learned that Denso and Merrill extending its production pause through Friday, March 27th, except in limited areas with additional protection.